Hi guys, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mait, and today we're going to talk about the number one question I get asked on the lot, and that is, what can my truck tow and how do I find out that information? We're going to show you that right now. Two common misconceptions on where to find your tow rating. One is the sticker on the side of your door. The GVWR actually is talking about the gross vehicle weight rating of what the truck weighs itself, the chassis, the fluids, the passengers, the cargo inside the truck, not including a trailer behind it. Your second misconception is finding your tow rating on the receiver hitch on the back. This is actually a tow rating just for the receiver hitch. That does not take in consideration your transmission, your engine, your brakes, things like that. The best place to find your towing capacity for your truck is in your owner's manual. There's a few things that they will ask for when doing that. One, what size is your truck? This happens to be a 2500, so yours could be a 1500, 2500, 3500. They'll ask what size cab you have, a regular cab versus an extended cab versus a crew cab. Another thing they'll ask is, what size is your bed? Is it a standard short box bed, which is about a 5.5 to 6.5 foot bed, or is it a long bed that is an 8 foot bed? And last, is it a 4x4 or 4x2? As you can see here in our manual, the maximum trailer weight for our 2500 series four wheel drive crew cab standard box, so short box, is 9,400 pounds. Now this one happens to be the 4:10 ratio, and so my trailer rating would be actually 13,000 pounds, or if I'm pulling a fifth wheel, 13,900. Now there's a couple reasons why you want to contact your local truck dealership. One is to find out your axle ratio if you don't have the build sheet to it. Two, they might be able to tell you some upgrades like a bigger transmission cooler or airbags or something like that to increase your towing capacity. A couple places to find your VIN number. One is the driver's side of your dash, the side of your door, or even on your registration. Now that we've figured out what our truck can tow, let's figure out what this 2017 Stealth weighs. The three numbers that you want to know about on a trailer is, one, the unloaded vehicle weight. Some people call that the dry weight. Also the cargo carrying capacity, which is how much can the camper handle other than itself inside the camper. And then the GVWR, which is the gross vehicle weight rating. That's the dry weight plus the cargo carrying capacity combined into one. To figure out what your towing capacity is and your total weight on this trailer, what you're going to do is you're going to take your dry weight, which is in this case 6689, plus all the gear that you're going to bring. So that's say 500 pounds. So, and then also you're going to take 200 pounds worth of water, let's say, and maybe gas or propane, and that's 700 pounds. And then let's say, since this is a toy hauler, that you put a 500 pound bike in the back. Now that's a total of 1200 pounds. So you take your 6689 dry weight or unloaded vehicle weight plus 1200, that gives you 7889. Now you'll notice that's not your total GVWR, which is 10,000 pounds on this guy. That's okay, you'll just take your dry weight plus all the stuff you're bringing with you, and that's what you need to be able to tow. You will need a brake controller to pull your trailer. This particular truck has an integrated brake controller right here, not to be confused with the tow button that's usually on the steering column. In addition, you'll need a 7-way plug on the back of your truck, because that's what most campers come with. A flat 4 is what you also see a lot of times, but that's usually for something much smaller, like a boat trailer or something like that that does not have brakes. The other thing that this 7-way plug has is a charge line that charges your battery as you're pulling it down the road, in addition to the brakes. One other important thing to note is tongue weight. So this camper has a tongue weight of how much force is being forced down onto the truck. For example, this guy has a tow rating of 13,000 pounds, but it has a max tongue weight of 1,500 pounds. Your tongue weight rating can actually change depending on if you're using a weight distribution hitch or not. Let me show you what one of those look like. What this does is it distributes the weight throughout your truck so that the back of your truck isn't being weighed down and the front of your truck isn't being lifted up where you don't have enough weight on the front wheels. The cool thing about these particular hitches, this is the equalizer hitch and the E2 hitch, they come with a little deal here on the front that goes into the receiver of your truck, and it's so that you can adjust to the correct height of the trailer versus the truck. The other cool thing I like about these guys is it has an anti-sway control built into them. And what that does is it makes it so it doesn't fishtail behind you as you're pulling the trailer down the road. Here in our parts store, we do sell the brake controllers, different types, as well as the harnesses. You may have a harness inside your glove box. So look for a little harness that kind of looks like this. And if you have one, great. Just otherwise, just make sure that you tell us that you don't have one so that we can have one here when you pick up your camper. So remember, guys, go ahead and get your VIN number and give your local truck dealer a call to figure out exactly what you can tow. We're here, of course, to help you out with any questions regarding weights and tongue weights and things like that for the trailer, as well as trying to help you get set up with the right brake controller and weight distribution hitch and things like that. Feel free to comment. I'll go ahead and respond to your comments if you have any questions that way, or you can email us, sales@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com, or our phone number, 970-313-4337. Thanks, guys.